has moved since home a few times, but received no answer. Worried, he ended up driving over to the house to check. He found the lights and radio were on, and the doors were locked. He knocked and rang the doorbell, but Evelyn never answered. He looked through one of the windows and saw his daughter's glasses and one of her shoes lying on the living room floor. After walking around, he found an open window to the basement. The screen had been removed and placed against the outside wall, and a small stepladder was positioned directly below it inside. Richard entered through the window and found Evelyn's other shoe inside the basement. He searched each room, found no sign of his daughter, but saw baby Janice was sound asleep in her crib. In the living room, Evelyn's school books were scattered and her glasses were broken. He called the police, who found pry marks on three of the windows, showing someone had attempted numerous times to break inside before entering through the basement. There were several areas where blood was present, which matched Evelyn's blood type. There were two pools in the yard, and more located inside the house, near the basement window. A bloody handprint was located on the wall of the garage, and more stains on the outside of a neighbor's house. Given the amount of blood at the scene, it was theorized that Evelyn's abductors had been carrying her through the yard, but had to stop and put her on the ground. Footprints were also located by the basement window and in the living room, which appeared to have come from a pair of sneakers. Several days after Evelyn disappeared, a pair of blood-stained underwear and a brassiere were found 2 miles south of La Crosse. The blood in the underwear was determined to be menstrual blood of Evelyn's blood type. A pair of blood-stained men's pants were found 4 miles down the same road. More items were later found: a pair of size 11 Goodrich sneakers and a size 36 denim jacket. Again, the blood on these items matched Evelyn's blood type, and the shoes had a pattern similar to those footprints found at the Rasmussen's home. During the first year, over 3,500 individuals were interviewed. Evelyn's father and Viggo Rasmussen were given polygraphs and passed. Investigators were never able to connect the evidence to anyone. It is thought that this was not a random crime, and perhaps the regular babysitter was the real target.